Well, hello everybody, and welcome to the National Portrait Gallery this morning. As Nicholas said, I'm Jennifer Scott, Director of the Holburne Museum in Bath, and I have been really looking forward to this day from the moment that Caroline invited me to be here, because I've always really enjoyed being part of the Understanding British Portraits network, and this is the high point in our year. And what a wonderful programme we've got today of some great speakers who are going to be looking at exactly the things that inspire us to work with portraiture in the first place. The thing about portraits that most inspires me, and working at the Holburne Museum, I imagine a lot of you have been there, particularly with the Understanding British Portraits trip there in summer 2014. The thing that really inspires me most about portraits is the thing that we often take so for granted. And I'm sure many of us in this room are used to sort of unpicking it, unraveling the great mystery of portraiture for people and saying, well, the great thing is it's about three things. Of course, it's about the sitter. And here at the National Portrait Gallery, we remember that so clearly, that excitement of the person who is being depicted. But then there comes the artist and that indelible relationship between the two of them, the moment in history when the artist captures the sitter. But then there is the person who pays for the portrait, not always directly related or linked to the artist or the sitter. And so these three things come together. And in our scholarship, we are able to look at this, to look at the context, to unravel the background to these portraits so that then we can understand more about them, and then the key to great scholarship, we can then make it accessible to others, to as broad an audience as possible. So we write our articles, we do our research, and then we create interpretative tools, we put on displays, we curate learning programs to draw out these stories. Because ultimately, portraiture, as we all know, is the most exciting part of art history, because not only is it about great art, but it's also about people. Now we say that, the three main parts, the key aims of portraiture, but in fact there is a fourth part that I sometimes forget. And we have our first speaker this morning who is best placed to talk to us about that. The buildings. The context of display, the places in which the portraits were intended to be shown, because that has such an influence on the artist, on the sitter, and on the patron. And so this morning's speaker is Wendy Hitchmoe, who is the head of buildings and research at Historic Royal Palaces. She's currently working on a project involving the Banqueting House. Those of you who know Wendy knew that before, she used to be the deputy director at Charleston. And today she is looking at the context, the setting of portraiture. So I'm going to hand over to Wendy for her lecture, which is titled Setting the Stuart Dynasty. Thank you, Wendy. Thank you.